You have a book called Black Supremacy.
Right.
And what does that mean, Black Supremacy?
Black supremacy means that Black people have supreme courage, supreme resilience. No people on the face of the planet have been oppressed more than Black people, but no group of people have made more significant contributions historically than Black people.
Really? And why nobody see it? You don't see it anywhere.
You don't see what?
Black historical accomplishments.
That's a part of the oppression and the hidden history. Not far from here, there's a guest you've had on your show, Tariq Nasheed.
Yes.
He has a museum called the Hidden History Museum, which is highlighting some of the accomplishments of Black people. There aren't many in America because they want to hide the truth. That's the problem. And that's probably why he named the museum the Hidden History Museum. They hide the truth of Black history.
And so if Blacks are supreme, why they keep chasing white people and accusing them and asking for affirmative action and reparations and telling the white people, we want to be a part of your schools, we want to be a part of your everything, but you're going to have to lower the standards so that we don't have to worry about passing the test to get in and all that. Why don't Black people go and just do their own thing rather than chasing white people if they are Black supremacy?
Well, I talk about that in the book. Black people should have built our own institutions. We should have our own organizations, and we shouldn't chase after these.
But why don't they know if they're superior?
No. The Black people who follow, I say that in the first page of the book, the Black people who follow the teachings, the history, the actions of their ancestors that allowed them to be successful in the face of oppression, those are the supreme Black people. The Black people who are following after other groups of people, after other race of people, those aren't your Black supremacists. Those aren't the people who are supreme.
Who are the supreme Blacks?
The ones who follow the actions and behaviors and history that allowed their ancestors to be successful. So Frederick Douglass was successful even though he was born a slave.
And where is Frederick now?
He's dead.
I rest my case.
Benjamin Banneker.
I'm talking about now. What's wrong with the Blacks?
Well, I'm successful.
What's wrong with the Blacks that they are constantly complaining about the white man and trying to keep up with him? And they right now they're out of control as far as snatch and grab and robbing and stealing and raping and killing white people and breaking into their stores and all that. If they're superior, why are they doing those things?
Those aren't the superior Blacks.
Ooh, those are the inferior ones?
Yes, the ones who
and
do stuff like that.
And why don't the superior one help the inferior one?
We do.
How?
And we try.
How?
Like how I do it. I educate Black youth. None of my students would ever do anything like that.
Oh, they wouldn't?
No.
Amazing.
And I have hundreds of students.
Do you teach at a Black Israelite school or something?
No, I teach at a New York
you
City
You teach at a normal school?
Right, if you want to call it normal, it's normally oppressive. But what you said, why we're asking for affirmative action is only way to protect Black people. In the 1950s and 60s, they would prevent Black people from, 1940s and 50s, they would prevent Black people from going to schools. They would follow them from NAACP meetings. They would follow them from Black Panther meetings. And they would make sure that they weren't going to college. They would harass them. Kick them out of schools.
When you say that, you're saying white people would do that to the
right.
Black.
And the people who were in charge of the institutions.
And so, the Black people back there was trying to get into the white schools?
Well, they were just trying to go to schools in general.
To Black schools or white schools?
A lot of them were trying to go to WPIs.
Were they trying to go
PWIs.
To Black schools or white schools?
PWIs, predominantly white, predominantly white institutions.
And so if they were superior, why were they trying to go to white school rather than just building their own school and doing their own thing like the Jews did?
We have built our
own. Why were they trying to force their way into the white school?
No, schools or colleges. We have our own colleges.
Whichever one you're talking about.
They call HBCUs.
But even there,
they were kicking Black people out of HBCUs.
why were the blacks trying to force their way into the white schools if they're superior?
The HBCU, historically black colleges.
Whichever one you're saying that they were kicking the blacks out.
Those are supposed to be black schools. Black colleges.
Stay with me. You said back in the 40s and 50s, right?
Right.
That they were, or 60s or whatever you said, they were kicking the blacks out of the school, they were following them and doing all that. Were the blacks trying to get into the white school back then?
Some were.
If they're superior, why were they trying to force their way into the white schools?
Because they didn't know that they were superior.
They didn't know it?
No.
Oh, you could be superior and not know it?
Yes.
Why were they so dumb that they didn't know they were superior?
They weren't dumb, they were just ignorant. There's a difference
between... How can you be superior and be ignorant that you're superior?
There's a difference between ignorance and stupidity.
And
there's a difference between knowledge and intelligence. Knowledge is what you know. Intelligence is how you utilize what you know.
So you could be superior and not know it?
Yes. So a lot of people don't know it, which is why I wrote this book.
Define superior for me.
Exceptionally greater than.
Exceptionally greater than.
Right.
And so the blacks were exceptionally greater than the whites?
Historically speaking, what I'm saying is no group of people have been oppressed as much as black people, and no group of people have made the significant contributions that black people have made. That's a historical fact.
But you're saying that the black people were superior when they were trying to force their way into the white schools, meaning that they were way smarter than the whites and they were superior to the whites.
You said that.
Well, superior, whatever your definition.
Okay.
But they didn't know it.
Yes.
So how can you be, so superiority doesn't come from God?
What?
It doesn't come from God.
What doesn't come from God?
To be superior.
To be superior doesn't come from God?
Right.
Anything we do comes from God.
So how come the black, how could they be superior and didn't know it?
Because many don't know the truth. Like Deuteronomy 7 and 6 tells you that God has a chosen people. I know that I'm a part of those chosen people. If more black people knew that, then they would carry themselves like it.
So if they had read the Bible, they would have known that they were superior?
If they read it and understood it properly, yes.
They would have known they were superior.
Right.
So you can't know that you're superior unless you read the Bible?
No, you can know that without reading the Bible.
But why didn't they know it then?
They were ignorant.
But why though? If you're superior...
Systemic racism.
If you're smarter than the white
systemic
people...
Systemic racism. So
and you're
talking about you're talking about in the 1940s and 50s,
I'm
right?
talking about this time when you said that the white people were... Like keeping
right.
the
no.
black people out of the
yeah.
school,
so staying with
falling
the,
out
staying
home.
With the, staying with the timeline, we weren't far removed from slavery and Jim Crow. During the 1940s and 50s, we still had people, black people in slavery under peonage.
But I'm one of those slow and didn't know I was superior. But how can you be superior than everybody else and not know it?
I'm going to tell you. So one of the slaves, one of the most famous slaves from the 1940s and 50s, we're talking about the 1940s and 50s, this lady was a slave. Her name is May Louise Miller. She was a slave in the 1950s and didn't even know that slavery was over, had been abolished.
But I'm asking you, how can you be superior and not know it to the rest of everybody else? Here you are fighting, trying to get into the white man's schools. Mm-hmm. And to their businesses because you think you can see that their stuff is better than yours, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you're superior, wouldn't you like naturally do superior things?
We do naturally do superior things.
Like break into white people's business?
No, like run the fastest, jump the highest, things like that.
No.
Usain Bolt, no one has ever run faster than him.
Animals do that.
Huh?
Animals
no,
do
I'm
that
talking about with people.
But you don't have to be superior to run fast. You just
if you
run.
If you run so faster than everyone else, you're superior.
But you really believe that white people, that black people are superior to the whites?
Look, no, you're saying something that's subjective. Objectively, no group of people, no race of people have been oppressed like black people and have made the significant contributions that black people have made. So when it comes to resilience and innovativeness, black people are superior. Objectively speaking, name a group of people who have been oppressed more than black people, then name a group of people who have made more inventions than black people.
The white people.
Really? When were they oppressed more than us?
Even right now.
When were they oppressed more than us?
Right now, they've been oppressed for the last 70 years.
70?
Yeah, the black people.
So
black people been blaming them, taking their stuff, calling them racist.
That's not true.
Beating their children, calling it knockout games.
That's not true.
Robbing and raping their homes.
That's not
taking
true.
Taking their purses on the streets.
That's
telling
not true.
Them if you disagree, you're a racist.
That's not and true.
You don't know all that's happening?
No, not the way you're saying
you
it.
You got all those degrees and you're not, not aware the way that you're that saying is it. Happening to the white man.
And it's happening to black people too.
No, no, no.
Knockout, they no, hit, no, they no. hit everyone when they play knockout.
Save me with that. You got all those degrees and you don't know that the things I just named are happening to white people?
The stuff you named are happening to more than just
white
people.
No, no, no. You asked me to name any group that been more oppressed than black people, and I told you the whites. And it's happening right now. You said it's not happening,
but
right?
But when you name the stuff, you can't name stuff that's also not happening to black people.
But
and
you
other
asked me
people.
Who are more depressed than the black. Right, I told you the whites.
No, but you name
white
stuff that's happening.
White people are scared to speak up to the black.
You name stuff that's happening to us, too. Black people are scared to speak up to whites and everyone.
Not.
Yes,
no,
they are.
No, they're not.
Yeah, oh, yes, they are. Mm-mm. At my school, I'm the only one who speaks up. When the people who are in charge of the school who are white, when they come in and say they want to hang up LGBTQIA flags around the whole school and stuff like that, I'm the only one who speaks up. The black people want to keep their job.
But white people are more afraid to speak up than any other race I ever
no,
seen.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are.
Black people
They're
are.
Being attacked by everybody.
Black
I saw
people
a
are
sign, I saw an ad that says something like, because I don't remember exactly how it went, says 19-something, Jews have been attacked or something like that. Racism or hatred for the Jews have gone up. And then it added the Jews, hatred for the Jews, the blacks, the Muslims, and the Asian. They didn't put white people in it. They didn't talk about the hatred for white people that have gone up. But I still want to know, being all these degrees you have, why you didn't know that white people are being suppressed and attacked more than any other race ever?
More than any other race ever? More than black people?
Yes.
That's ridiculous.
Why?
Because even by your own knowledge of history, where they say black slaves came to the Americas in 1619, which black people were here before that, but from 1619 to the abolishment of slavery in 1865, that's 250 years right there. Where's the 250 years of oppression for white people?
Ever since they, I don't know if all that stuff you just said is true or not, but come black make up stuff too. But
that's the white historical narrative point of view.
Let me ask you something about, so say yes or no to me. White, black people are superior to all other races, right?
Yes.
Yes, but they don't know it.
The majority?
Do they know that they are superior to all other races?
The majority don't know that.
So you could be superior of over all other races and not know it.
Right, if you don't
know.
And
who gave them that superiority?
It's God.
Who?
God.
The Israelite God?
Your God, the same God.
Which one is that?
The God of the Bible.
Which one is that?
Of the Bible.
Which one is that, though?
Yahweh.
Who?
Yahweh.
The hour?
Yahweh.
Who is Yahweh?
God. That's his name.
What the?
The Tetragrammaton.
Okay, but let me do this. You talked about Jim Crow law, right?
Right.
And were blacks suppressed during Jim Crow law?
Yes.
And were they superior to the whites during that time, too?
Yes.
But they didn't know it?
No.
They had this hidden superiority and didn't know it?
Right.
Amazing. And so if blacks were suppressed during Jim Crow law, why were they doing better then than they are today?
Because of systemic racism that has a lot of black people caught up in a system.
Okay, no, I'm saying, so why were they doing better under Jim Crow law than they are now that white people are afraid of them and they can do whatever they want?
Well,
why were the blacks doing better then than they are now if they were suppressed then?
Black people aren't following the guidelines that I have in this book now. So when they came in the late 1960s, no, the late 1970s, and they implemented the no man in the house law.
I know about all that, but I'm asking you, why were the blacks better off under the Jim Crow law than they are now? They're worse off today.
I took in a chapter in this book is called The Nuclear Black Family. In the early 1950s and 1960s, we at least had the nuclear black family where you had the black man, the black woman, and child. And the black man led the household. That's one of the key things that
right.
we had that
so
allowed us to be more
why
successful.
Why don't y'all put that back together?
This is a part of, this is what I'm saying. When I say—
But how is that superior to anybody?
See, this is what I'm saying with superiority. We're superior because we have been oppressed the most and still made the most significant contributions, so our resilience is superior. That's what makes us superior.
That doesn't even make sense.
It does. If you can make the most significant contributions face of oppression, that shows some superiority.
Who destroyed the black family?
Systemic racism.
Who?
Who? White supremacists.
White supremacy destroyed the black family?
Right, systemic racism.
They made black men leave their homes?
They locked black men up, yes.
Did they make black men leave their home and for the welfare check?
Yes.
They made them do it?
They didn't make them do it. It rewarded black women who kicked black men out the house.
But, right, and so is the black woman superior to?
The black woman what?
Superior to all the other women? Other races of women?
By my definition?
No, yeah.
Yes.
They are superior to everybody else?
Yes, by my definition.
And so if black women are superior, why did they choose to accept the welfare check over the husband?
You're twisting it. They're superior when they operate with the actions that their ancestors operated with.
Right, but their ancestors, at that time, they were not getting a welfare check. They were getting husbands. Right?
Exactly.
And so if they were superior, why did they choose the welfare check over the husband? The white man came along mm-hmm. and said, here's a welfare check, but you can't have a husband. Mm-hmm. Why did this black superior woman decide, you know, a welfare check is better than a husband?
Ignorance. Oh, ignorance.
So the superior woman was ignorant?
Exactly.
She didn't know she was superior?
You're not going to act in a way that allows you to be superior when you're ignorant.
So she didn't know she was superior?
No.
And so she chose the welfare check over the husband.
Right, because she didn't know what best served the black community.
And the black husband didn't know he was superior.
Well, it depends on who you're talking
about. Back then, he didn't know he was superior?
It depends on which one you're talking about. Not all black men left.
Those that did leave, they didn't know they were superior?
No. The ones who know act in a way that serves their community best.
You got all those degrees, and this makes sense to you?
Yes, it makes a lot of sense. Did you read the book?
Let me ask.
Exactly.
Did you know that it wasn't a white man that did that? It was the civil rights movement, black people?
That did what?
Told black people that, you know what, you're being oppressed. You need some free stuff. You need welfare checks. You need to become Democrats, and we're going to be your leaders.
It wasn't
because at that time, more black people were Republicans rather than Democrats, right? And so Martin Luther King and all those guys came along with their little civil rights movement, which was the worst thing that ever happened to the blacks. You would agree with that, right?
The civil rights movement?
Yeah. It was the worst thing that ever happened to the blacks other than abortion.
A part of the civil rights movement that I don't agree with, which Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. later recanted, was I don't agree with desegregation. I believe that that was harmful.
Do you believe that the civil rights movement was the worst thing that ever happened to blacks in the history of black people
other than
abortion?
So you would say it's worse than slavery?
Yes.
And that makes sense to you?
Yes. 100% makes sense. So which makes sense, to kill the man's baby in the womb or to be enslaved physically?
I don't agree with abortion.
Which makes sense, to which one is worse, to kill the man's baby in the womb or to be enslaved physically?
They're both just as harmful.
Which is worse?
Who said the one was worse?
Which is worse, to kill the man's baby in the womb or to be enslaved physically?
Who said one was worse? They're the same.
I'm asking you, which is worse?
I don't think one is worse. I think they're both terrible. Both of them deplete the black community.
But which one is worse?
That's like, which shoe is better, your right shoe or your left shoe?
So killing a man, baby in the womb, and being a slave are both the same to you physically?
They're not the same physically. Physically,
I'm saying being a
slave, I think the torture is worse physically.
I said being a slave physically and being an innocent child in a womb, they both are the same to you?
No, physically being born and being in a womb are not the same thing. As far as depletion of the black community, they're equal. If you continue to kill black babies, there would be no black people. If you enslave black people and you torture them and you tell them that they're inferior and you prevent them from having an education, that also depletes the black community. So,
amazing.
Yes.
So you don't think one is worse than the other?
No.
Oh, okay. Let me ask. I grew up under the Jim Crow law, you know that, right?
Yes.
Down in Alabama, right?
You're 74,
and everything
correct.
That they tell you about that is a lie. Black people were better off. They didn't hate the white man. They had families. They went to black schools and they were thriving. As for education, they would go to black colleges. Mm-hmm. They were quite satisfied with that. They would come back as teachers and professors. And they would get married. Mm-hmm. They would teach their children to work and think and be for themselves.
That's not true.
They treated other people the way they would like to be treated.
Right.
Treated, never mind the color. They didn't let you play with bad black children or bad mm-hmm. white children. They loved all people. They didn't hate anyone. It wasn't until the Civil Rights Movement started mm-hmm. that they told them, oh, y'all need, especially blacks in Montgomery, the cities and places uh-huh. like that, they told them, y'all need more. And the black people said, oh yeah, we do need more. And they fell for the lies. As a matter of fact,
that's not true.
That when they started the whole little Civil Rights Movement thing,
yeah.
and that black woman got on the bus.
What Rosa was her Parks?
Name? Yeah, what a bunch of crap she was, right?
Whoa.
She originally, the NAACP had chosen another black girl to sit on the bus and act like uh-huh. she was tired.
Yeah.
And she ain't gonna sit on the front of the bus.
Jesse.
But they found out that she was pregnant just before they did the thing. Uh-huh. And they knew that black people were not gonna accept that because black people were not at that time accepting out of wedlock birth as a
right.
norm.
Mm-hmm.
And so they found out this girl was pregnant. And they like, we can't use her. Black ain't gonna fall for this. And then they went and fought Rosa Parks and told Rosa Parks, you know, go and let you tired.
Jesse.
And sit on the front row. And Rosa like, I'm so tired. That thing was a whole setup.
Okay.
It wasn't like one day Rosa Parks would come home and she was just tired and decide to sit at
you
the front
row. You know you mixed the truth with
row,
a lie?
And not... And just sit there, I'm so tired, I ain't going to no back of no bus. Yeah. That was a plot. It was a plan by the NAACP.
So my
you
father,
you didn't know that?
My father's older than you.
You didn't know that?
My father's older than you.
No, answer that first and then tell about your dad.
Know what?
That was a setup by the NAACP.
Okay, well, she had connections with the NAACP.
Did you know that was a setup?
I don't know it was a setup. I know she had connections with the
I've
NAACP.
I've read about it, I've talked about it. And most black people know about it mm-hmm. because even when the NAACP started a little mess,
right.
the older black people, my grandparents and their parents were saying, don't be a part of that, that's just mess.
Whether
with Martin Luther King and all that, don't
a setup
y'all follow
not,
that mess.
Whether it was a setup or not, it was necessary because black people weren't
a
being treated.
A setup like that was necessary?
They weren't treated fairly on the bus. And that was a time when blacks
the bus.
Were unified for a year. For a year, in order to
get
treated fairly on the bus, in order that ended the segregation on the bus after 1 year of protesting and
did
boycotting
you know,
in Montgomery.
Did
Alabama.
You know that when the NAACP set that up,
uh-huh.
that there were black buses owned bus companies?
Right, there was.
And
there
when were. They set that up, made the black people say, "Don't be riding those white buses," right?
Mm-hmm.
It caused, according to reports, it caused black business to go out of business. The black buses business to go out of business.
It wasn't a lot. It wasn't as many black bus companies as white. But they should have just the ones who could have accessed the black buses should have just went on the black buses. But they weren't.
But they hurt the black business by doing that.
They did. So, but back to what you said. My father's older than you, and my father's from the South. My father grew up in South Carolina.
Right. I grew up in Alabama.
Yeah, the South. So my father tells me stories. Shout out to my father. His name is James McKithen. I'll give him a shout out. And my mom, Miss James. But my father's older than you, and he tells me stories about, you know, how he grew up, and he worked on a plantation. And he did say, you know, he got along with,
I was there.
He was there before you. He's older than you.
White people got along better than they do today.
What?
Because the white people are sick of the black people. Everybody's
sick of them. You said
sick
and dogs on them? What'd you say?
I said that white people and black people got along way better than they are today.
You said the water hoses?
I said that white people are sick of the blacks complaining.
You said the lynchings?
So what though?
The lynchings?
Did you know that there were, I think, something like 4,000 blacks who owned slaves?
4,000 blacks who owned slaves?
In Kentucky or one of those areas.
What source is that? No, what's your source?
One of my hosts talked about it the other day on the show. But you didn't know that.
No,
huh?
What's the source?
All your little black supremacy book. You didn't look that up.
No, what source is that?
Let's do this. We'll
that's a lie.
Put it up there.
You ever heard of the book by James Lowe, The Lies My History Teacher Told Me? That would be in it. That's a lie.
Why don't black people just kind of move on with their lives and stop this mess that they're into? If they're superior, why don't they somehow or another let their little superior stuff kick in and stop blaming and living in the past, which had nothing to do with them, by the way. Living in
nothing
the past
to do with home.
And blaming the whites and other. At what point would they say, you know what, we had enough complaining and being victims and, and talking about this mess. Let's show everybody what we can do. Why don't they forget about the past and live in the present?
Well, the past affects the present.
No, it doesn't. So,
yes, it does.
Not if you don't live in it.
There's no way to get around it. It does.
Yes, there's a way to
the
get around it.
The past is still in the present.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Only in your mind.
In 2015, in Miami, Florida, they were shooting at, in a police department, they were shooting at black civilians' pictures, mugshots. At a police department.
When was this?
In 2015, in Miami, Florida. 2015? 2015.
What year is it now?
That's 8 years ago.
What year is it right now?
2023.
But what's the purpose of living in the past?
So yesterday is the past.
What's the purpose of living in yesterday?
You have to know your history in order for history not to repeat itself and to improve yourself.
That's not true.
That is true.
Knowing your history does not is what making things worse. So if people know their history, they've been talking about this mess for years, right? Knowing their history, why are they still repeating the same thing over and over again?
They don't know their history. If you know the history that's in this book, they know the history that they want to teach. When we talk about systemic racism, do you know that in 2015?
You believe that racism exists?
Yes.
And what is racism?
I'll tell you. So racism is the unfair treatment of one group of people based on their race, or the belief that one group of people is inferior solely based off their race. So
you are racist for believing that black people are superior to others?
For saying that we have superior resilience.
Are you a racist for believing that black people are superior to all other races, you said?
No, I'm not racist.
But you just said that was racism.
No, I said solely based on race. Mine's is not solely based on race.
So you believe...
Mine's are based off black accomplishments and black oppression.
So racism is a belief that one race is superior to another, right?
Solely based on race.
But racism is, according to you, a belief that one race is better than the other.
Solely based on race, correct.
And so if white people think they're better because they do better than black people, they see that they're smarter, they're more innovative.
They're not smarter. They're not more innovative.
They're more or less to blame others and carry on.
No, they're not.
Does that make them superior to the blacks?
Nothing you said was true.
Does that make them superior?
No,
racist
it doesn't.
To the black because they do more?
They don't do more.
They do more.
What do you mean they do more?
They're keeping the country going while black people are chasing them trying to get it and destroying it.
Destroying what?
Everything they touch.
I'm black. I don't destroy everything I touch.
You may be one black that don't be, but most blacks do.
No, most blacks do what?